In this Teamwork 5 employee tutorial, I'm going to show you how to use the filter option that Teamwork 5 offers in many of its charts. To do that, go to your top menu bar and click on Swap. Anytime you see this little filter symbol on the chart, you are able to rearrange the way the information in that chart is displayed. I'm going to go to my schedule because it has more items in the chart and you'll get a better idea of how this function works. Again, I could have showed you how the filter works in the swap board. It will work exactly the same there. I just want you to be able to see all of the different options, and to do that I need more things in the chart. Anytime you see the little filter symbol in the chart, you have the ability to click on that category, drag it to the top, and rearrange the chart based on that category. So what that means is, if you work at two different locations, you can click the filter symbol next to location, click on it and drag it to the top, and your shifts will rearrange based on location. If I scroll down, you can see that at the top is after hours, which is a restaurant, and at the bottom is all locations. I requested leave, and so that is for any location. If I worked somewhere else, that would also appear as an option. Let's say that I also want to break my shifts down based on station. I can click the little filter symbol next to station, drag it to the top, and now my shifts are arranged first based on the location and then based on the station. As you can see, I can work as a bus person or as a cashier. The items in the chart are automatically arranged in alphabetical order or numerically if it's a date or some other number. If I want to flip that arrangement, so instead of going from A to Z, it's the backwards alphabet going from Z to A, I can click the arrow next to the word station, and the shifts will rearrange themselves in reverse alphabetical order. I could do the same thing to location if I wanted, and it would just flip the order. I can add as many of these options as I want. Let's say I also want to arrange it based on hours. I can click the little symbol next to hours and drag it to the top, and now Teamwork 5 will arrange the chart based on my hours. If I want to change the order of this filtering system, let's say that I want it broken down by hours and then station. I can click on hours, drag it over, and place it in between location and station, and Teamwork 5 will rearrange my shifts. If I no longer care about the location part, all I have to do is click the X symbol next to location, and Teamwork 5 will take that filter off the chart. And I can do the same thing with the other filters. I can exit out of hours, and I can exit out of station. And now I'm back to the regular orientation of my chart. There is one other thing you can do with your filter. If you click on one of your filter symbols, a pop-up menu will come up, and it's going to allow you to enter in a word or phrase that you want Teamwork 5 to filter by. For example, under station, I could say, I only want to look at my bus shifts. So I will type in bus, and then if I like that, I will go to the bottom and hit filter. And now I am only seeing the shifts I'm scheduled to work that are my bus shifts. If I go back up to that filter and click on it again, I could add a second filter option. So let's say that I want shifts that are also my cashier shifts. I can type in cashier, and I don't have any shifts that are both bus and cashier, so I'm going to change this and to or. That way it'll show me both types of shifts. Otherwise, it would only show me the shifts that are both bus and cashier. So now I will hit filter, and Teamwork 5 will show me all of my cashier and bus shifts. I can go back up to that filter, and I can change this to show me, instead of all of my bus shifts, everything that's not a bus shift. To do that, I will click this arrow, and as you can see, there are lots of options from this drop-down menu. I'm going to go ahead and choose Does Not Contain, and I will hit Filter. Now I see all of my shifts except my bus shifts. If I want to see my unfiltered schedule again, I can go back up to that same filter, click on it, and hit clear. And now I'm back to my regular unfiltered schedule. Notice that that filter is no longer highlighted in yellow. That means that it's not in use. When it was highlighted in yellow, it was in use. And that's how you use the filter option in TeamWork 5. Again, that filter option will function just like this in any chart in TeamWork 5 that has that little symbol in it. To learn more about your TeamWork 5 account, check out the next video.